Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. In the final episode of this six-part video series, we'll go undercover and switch our day scope into a night vision scope. Now you've been tasked with switching the scope over to night vision. Now action is for 3D compositing and pixel deformation. For image filtering effects, we need to use other tools that will eventually be fed into the action composite. Press the home icon to return to the default Connect Effects view. We want to affect the background image with the night vision effect. At this point, I would like you to note that the background is being fed into three different places in the node tree. Now you can manually disconnect and reconnect everything, or we can auto-insert the node before these three connections. Select the image node. Hover over the Connect Effects node bin and press D for the damage node. Now press Shift and Option at the same time. You will see the three connections highlight. At this point, release the Option keyboard shortcut, but carry on pressing Shift. So with Shift pressed, double-click on the damage node. This will auto-insert itself into the image node and feed into the three connections. Now let's load the night vision preset. Select the damage node. Click the drop-down arrow next to the presets button. Choose night vision and press confirm. It's not a bad start to work with, but let's tweak it further. Double-click on the damage node to see its menus. Let's first work on the scan lines. Click the scan lines button. Change the scale to 5 to make the scan lines thicker. Now drop the transparency to 35%. Next, switch to the color menu. Set the contrast to 135. Set the brightness to 100. And set the color saturation to 50. The black areas are a little too dark for my liking. Click the color pot next to the shadows header. In the color picker, change the color mode to HSL. Drag the luminance slider upwards to add a touch of dark gray into the shadows. Click OK to accept the changes. I'm pretty satisfied with that look, so click the action node to see the combined result. So that's not bad. Let's tweak the colors a bit more. Switch to the media menu. Select media entry 1 with the target image. Double click on the empty color correction box for the fill. In the color corrector, press F6 to see the action context view. Just drop the saturation down to 50. That's looking much better, but I want the edges to be brighter to emulate the night vision scope. Press return to exit the color corrector. Select the third media entry with the scope's edges. Double click the color correction box to edit the existing correction. Press F6 to see the action context view. Now push the gain up to 150. Press return to exit the color corrector. Scrub through the time bar to see the results so far. Go to the last frame. Now that the scope is in night vision mode, I would like to change the cursor color to yellow. In the ConnectFX schematic, select the color frame node for the crosshair. Change the color from white to yellow. Now click back to the action node to see the update in the result view. Connect the output of the action node into the ConnectFX output node. Exit ConnectFX and press render to process the final result. Stepping forward in time, here is the final result in the full screen player. So you can play a lot with the tools to get the look you want. Take your time and experiment with the tools. Throughout this series, we've covered masking, tracking, compositing, and stylizing with the damage node. I hope you found this series useful and enjoyable. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning Channel for future videos.